In this problem, the graphs of the function f and its derivative f dash are shown. Which is bigger, f dash minus 1 or f double dash 1? So for two graphs, it is asked that which one is bigger. So we can see in graph 1, we are given with red and black curves, right? So red curve shows us the maxima. So that's why it will be f dash of x, all right? So we can easily say this is f dash x. Okay, now simply again moving to the another graph, we are just identify which is fx and which is f dash of x, right? Okay, so here the black curve in the second curve, we can see the black curve is showing maxima, right? So this will be f dash x and red curve will be fx. All right, so first step is over now. Now for the second step, we are taking the first problem first. So here, f dash minus 1 is less than 0. So f dash minus 1, that is f dash minus 1 is 0 here. Okay, you can see here this is minus 1, right? So this will be 0 here. This is less than 0, you can say. I'm sorry, this should be here. Okay, here it should be minus 1, right? So it should be less than 0 here. Why? Because the y value is in the negative part, you can see here, right? So that's why we are taking less than 0. So this is, we are talking about the value for y. That's why fx is represented for the y. So x is the value for the x and y will be the value for fx, right? Or f dash x, you can say. So here we can easily say that in this graph, we can see this graph is going downwards. That means it has the value less than 0. Now for f dash of x, right? And x is equals to 1. So now f dash x at x is equals to 1. So here we can see the slope is 0 here, right? So that's why this f double dash 1 is greater than f dash of minus 1 here. Now for the second question, we can see here f dash minus 1 is greater than 0. F dash minus 1 is greater than 0. So here is the value and we are getting the black one in the upper side. So that will be the positive value, that is greater than 0 value in the y-axis. Can we see here? This is positive and this is actually negative, right? Negative value. Okay, so here when we put f double dash 1, right, equals to 0, so it becomes equals to 0 here. Right, so this is the way we can conclude that f dash minus 1 is greater than f double dash of 1. So remember the slope for is equals to 0 at f dash x when x is equals to 1 here. Can we see here? Yes, we can see here at f1, the slope is 0 here. Okay. So this is why we have got this answer. I hope you understood the concept. Thanks for watching.